as you're trying to fall asleep and as you're sleeping, I pray that your spirit, man, your spirit may be edified, with these biblical affirmations. Now, before we get started, let's go ahead and get comfortable. I believe God is going to do something great tonight in the lives of each and every viewer, in the lives of each and every listener. I believe God is going to do something great, and he's going to be edifying our spirit today with this video. I am so excited. I wrote down 40 biblical affirmations with the subject, and it starts off with I am. So many times we are so hard on ourselves. We are our biggest critics. Our biggest critics. We can say the most nastiest and most disturbing things to ourselves. But I believe that it's time to treat ourselves with love, respect. It's time for us to remind ourselves who we are. In Christ. God is such a great God. And I believe that he brought this video to you guys tonight so that you can sleep, so that you can rest in peace, knowing who you are. So I took the time today to write out 40 different biblical affirmations. And I have these little cards that we're gonna shuffle. And each card has a different biblical affirmation along with a Bible scripture to back it up. Because everything we say will be backed up by the Word of God. It's not coming from me. I'm not making things up. But everything I say on this channel will be backed up with the Word of God. And I'm so excited to start with these little flashcards that I have here for you guys. And we'll mix them up and we'll get started. But before we do, as always, we will pray. So go ahead if you can. Put on your headphones. Get comfortable. Dim those lights if you can. So that we can have the ultimate experience. So that we can have the ultimate experience with the Lord tonight. Go ahead and close your eyes. Heavenly Father, we give you honor, we give you glory, and we thank you for the opportunity to listen and to view to another video that is going to edify our spirits. Lord, we pray that tonight, that every viewer, every listener, as they try to rest, as they try to relax, as they try to let go of the frustration of the week, of the day and the month, that your Holy Spirit have an encounter with them. Lord, that your Holy Spirit may dwell inside of them. That as we say these biblical affirmations, Lord, you are removing the negative things that we have said about ourselves. We are removing, the Holy Spirit is removing every negative thing that people have said about us, the labels that have been placed on us, and that we can remember who we are in Christ Jesus, that we are loved, that we are your children, that we have power, authority, and dominion. And Lord, I pray for any person right now dealing with anxiety, dealing with insomnia, dealing with frustration, depression, any suicidal thoughts, Lord, we declare right now that your Holy Spirit be with them, Father God. That as they wake up in the morning, Father God, something has been lifted up off of them. Something will break. Lord, we declare that as they wake up in the morning, they will feel a change in them, Father God. A change in their mentality. A change in the way that they speak. A change in the way that they walk, Lord. A change in the way that they think. Lord, we declare, Father God, that you recognize and to remember who you are in Christ. Who you are in Christ. Now we're going to shuffle these. Shuffle. And we'll go ahead and pick one. And as always, this is still very ASMR style so that you can relax and unwind. The first card that we have here tonight says, I am forgiven. I am forgiven. I am forgiven. And the Bible verse that we have selected for I am forgiven is 1 John. 1 John chapter 2 verse 12. And it says, I am writing to you. I am writing to you, little children, because your sins are forgiven for his name's sake. 1 John chapter 2, verse 12 says, I am writing to you, little children, because your sins are forgiven for his name's sake. I am forgiven. So hard on ourselves sometimes, and sometimes we can't even forgive ourselves for things that we've done, for errors that we've done. But God says, you are forgiven. You are forgiven. And if he can forgive you, that means you can forgive yourself. Card number two says, I am chosen by the Father. I am chosen by the Father. I am chosen by the Father. 1 Peter chapter 2 verse 9 says, but you are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, his own special people, that you may proclaim the praises of him who called you out of darkness, his marvelous light. I am chosen by the Father. I am chosen by the Father. It says you are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation. Amen. This is a good one. It says, I am complete in Christ. I am complete in Christ. I am complete in Christ. Colossians 2 verse 10 says, and you have been filled in him who is the head of all rule and authority. Colossians 2:10 says, and you have been filled in him who is the head of all rule and authority. I am complete. I am complete in Christ. So many people do not feel complete and they have a void in their lives. But with Christ Jesus, you are complete. You are complete. God is so good. This one says, I am capable. I am capable. I am capable. If you're still meditating, if you're still awake, I want you to repeat that to yourself. I am capable. I am capable. Philippians 4:13 says, I can do all things through him who strengthened him. I can do all things through Christ who gave me strength. Philippians 4:13. I am capable. You are capable to start that business. You are capable to speak to that neighbor, that coworker, that family member about Jesus Christ. Christ, you are capable in starting a ministry and serving in your local church. You are capable to do all things because God Himself gives you strength, gives you strength. This one says, I am spiritually as you're feeling spiritually dead. The devil is a liar. The Bible says in Ephesians 2, verse 5, even when we were dead in our trespasses, made us alive together with Christ. By grace you have been saved. Made us alive together with Christ. By grace you have been saved. I am spiritually alive. I want you to repeat that self. I want your spirit man to receive that. I am spiritually alive. I don't care what it looks like. I don't care what you're going through. You will not die. You will not die. Your spirit will push through. Your spirit is alive. You are alive. You are alive. 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 I am chosen, holy, and dearly loved. I am chosen. Chosen. Holy. Holy. And dearly loved. Dearly loved. The Bible says in Ephesians chapter 1 verse 4, even as he chose us in him before the foundation of the world, that we should be holy and blameless before him in love. Ephesians 1 4 says, even as he chose us in him before the foundation of the world, that we should be holy and blameless before him in love. In love. I am chosen, holy, and dearly loved, and dearly loved. Let's move. Place some of these around here so that we can pick one as we go. Oh, I just found one. Are you ready for this one? Because I feel this on my spirit that so many of us feel that we are not useful. But tonight, I want you to remind yourself, I am useful. I am useful. The Bible says, another verse in Ephesians 2:10, for we are God's masterpiece. He has created us as a new in Christ Jesus. Created us as a new in Christ Jesus, so we can do the good things he planned for us long ago. We are God's masterpiece. God's masterpiece. I am useful. You are God's masterpiece. I am God's masterpiece. I am God's masterpiece. I want to remind you tonight that I am a friend of Jesus. I am a friend of Jesus. It says in John 15:15, no longer do I call you servants, for the servant does not know what his master is doing, but I have called you friends, for all that I have heard from my Father I have made known to you. But I have called you friends, for all that I have heard from my Father I have made known to you. You are a friend of hears us. Now notice it doesn't say if we ask for one thing, if we ask for some things, but it says that if we ask anything according to his will, he hears us. I am heard by God. Yes, you are. You are heard by God. You are heard by God. God hears you. Because if you ask anything according to his will, he hears you. He hears you. Oh, I just caught one that caught my attention. I am born of God. I am born of God, and evil cannot touch me. I am born of God, and evil cannot touch me. Not no plan from Satan, not no dart, not no arrow. Evil cannot touch me. The Bible says in 1 John chapter 5 verse 18, we know that everyone who has been born of God does not keep on sinning, but he who was born of God protects him, and the evil ones does not touch him. I'm gonna read that again. 1 John chapter 5 verse 18, we know that everyone who has been born of God does not keep on sinning, but he who was born of God protects him, and the evil one does not touch him. I am born of God, and evil cannot touch me. Evil cannot touch you. Evil cannot touch your children. Cannot touch your spouse. Evil cannot touch you. I am born of God, and evil cannot touch me. Evil cannot touch me. My God. the salt loses its flavor, how shall it be seasoned? It is then good for nothing but to be thrown out and trampled underfoot by men. You are the light of the world. A city that is on a hill cannot be hidden. You are the light of the world. You are the light of the world. You are the light of the world. You are the salt of the earth. You are the salt of the earth. So many affirmations tonight that are reminding us of who we are in Christ. The more you know who you are in Christ, the more you can live in liberty and in freedom. You are the salt of the earth. You are the light of this world. I am sheltered and protected in God. I am sheltered and protected in God. The Bible says in Colossians 3:3, for you have died and your life is hidden with Christ in God. I am sheltered and protected. I am sheltered and protected, for you have died and your life is hidden with Christ in God. Colossians 3:3. Colossians 3:3. God is just so good. Tonight he's reminding us that we are called, that we are chosen, that we are his temple, that we are protected, that we are the salt, that we are the light, that we have value, that we are joined to him, that we are one spirit, that we are kingdom-minded, that we are born of God and evil will not touch us, that your prayers are heard, that you are chosen, that you are loved, that you are a friend of Jesus. I am useful. I am chosen, holy, and dearly loved. You are spiritually, spiritually alive. You are never alone. You are victorious. You are fearless, fearless. I am fearless. I am capable. I am complete. I am chosen by the Father, and I am forgiven, 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 forgiven. I am grateful to be me. That alone is a big one. I am grateful to be me. So many times the enemy wants to come in and wants to make us compare our lives to other people, especially in the world that we live in with social media. He wants to bring the spirit of comparison and compare our lives to other people, and we wish that we had money, and we wish that we were famous, and we wish that our bodies looked a certain way. But tonight I am grateful to be me. You know why? Because there is only one you. There is only one you. God created you exactly how he wanted to create you. And the Bible says in Genesis 1 verse 31, then God saw everything that he had made. God saw everything, everything that he had made. And indeed, it was very good. So the NASB version, it says, for we are his workmanship. We are his workmanship. Workmanship created in Christ Jesus for God's work, which God prepared beforehand that we should walk in them. desires of your heart. I am successful. All of my desires, all of my dreams, according to the will of God, He will make it happen because I am successful. I want to remind you tonight on this next big one right here. It says, I am enough. I am. We're going to receive that tonight. Our spirit needs to be reminded of that tonight. I am. I am enough. You are enough. You are enough. I am enough. I am enough. And the Bible says in Galatians 3:26, for in Christ Jesus you are all sons of God through faith. And because you are in Jesus Christ, that means that you are enough. That means that you are enough. It says, for in Christ Jesus you are all sons of God through faith, because you are a son of the Most Living God, because you are a daughter, because you are a son of the Living God, of the King of Kings, of the Lord of Lords, of the Alpha and the Omega, of the beginning and the end. You are enough. You are enough. Because you have Jesus, you are enough. Because you have Christ, you are enough. Because you have Yahweh and Yeshua, you are enough. You are a daughter. You are a son of God, and therefore you are enough. I am 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 enough. And because I am enough, and because I am enough, I am accepted. I am accepted. I am accepted. I am accepted. The spirit of rejection tonight has to go in the mighty name of Jesus. So many people are struggling because they feel rejected by this world, rejected by their family, rejected by their friends, their co-workers, their jobs. But because you are enough, you are also accepted. I am accepted. The Bible says in Romans 15:7, therefore welcome one another as Christ has welcomed you for the glory of God. Therefore welcome one another as Christ has welcomed you for the glory. For the glory of God. I am accepted. I am accepted. I am accepted. The spirit of rejection tonight has to go. That burden, that spirit that has been telling you that you are by yourself, that you are rejected, that you will never be accepted, that you are the black sheep. We come against it right now in the mighty name of Jesus, and we remind you tonight that you are accepted. The Bible says, the Bible says in Romans 15 verse 7, therefore welcome one another as Christ has welcomed you for the glory of God. For the glory of God. I am accepted. I am enough. I am accepted. And because I am accepted, I am confident. I am confident. I am confident. I am confident to do the things that God has called me to do. I am confident. I am confident that I am enough. I am confident that I am accepted. I am confident. The Bible says in Psalms 46 verse 5, God is in the midst of His city, secure and never shaken. At daybreak, His help will be seen with the appearing of the dawn. I am confident because God is in the midst of His city. I am confident because God is in the midst of me. And there's another version that says God is in the midst of her. God is city, and I am secure, and I will never be shaken. God is in the midst of me. God is in the midst of me. I am confident, and because He is in the midst of me, I am secure. I am secure and never, never, never shaken. Never shaken. You are the daughter. depression has no place, anxiety has no place, insomnia has no place, fear, doubt, and frustration has no place. My God, and we declare that as we removed every negative thought, every doubt, every worry, every frustration, every negative word we've spoken about ourselves and people have spoken about us, and we've replaced it with a biblical affirmation, Lord, I declare that when we look at ourselves in the mirror, we will no longer recognize ourselves, that we will see ourselves with your eyes, with the eyes of Christ, that we see that we are daughters and sons of the King of Kings, that